Hi lovelies, it's me Sherry with Live Love Latte, and thanks for joining me for this organization video. I'm here in my master bathroom and I'm going to show you how I've organized underneath the master bathroom sink, both on my husband's side and on my side. So I've organized this space probably almost a year ago and I haven't touched it since, and I thought it was organized, but I realized through the months, and especially the last couple months I was really thinking about it, that I'm not really utilizing this space, and I wasn't looking forward to reaching underneath the sink and grabbing something that I needed. Managed to throw away almost a full kitchen trash bag of stuff, and they were things that I was never using, things that I wasn't going to use again, makeup that was expired, and I even managed to find two sentimental items that I've kept there for a few years, and they were pots where I used to have my favorite bamboo plants in that obviously died, and I kept thinking that I would plant new bamboo plants in them, but you know what, I just wasn't doing it. And so now I've decided to donate those, and on my countertop I try to keep it as clear as possible and just only put the things that I need to use every single day. But still, underneath the bathroom sink it was chaotic. It wasn't exactly the system I wanted, so when I would come into the bathroom, and you know, I was always thinking about underneath the bathroom sink. So I knew it was time to try to work out this new system. And so I'm excited to show you how I've turned this space from chaos to calm. So let's get started.
My husband's side of the sink, the cleaning caddy is here, and I have the same cleaning caddy underneath each of the bathroom sinks because I just like it to be uniform. I'll probably do another video to show you my cleaning products. And then here, these are the stacking bins that I was using. Here is a larger one, they're from Walmart, and I've just labeled them extra cleaning supplies, trash bags, and tabo. Tabo is actually Tagalog, and it's this mini pail that has a handle on it, and I fill it with water, and I use that to wash out the tub in the shower. And then on this side, I do have some travel bags, extra travel bags in there. Okay, and then you can see how the bins have that green bar across so that it stacks. And then this is where the hair dryer is, because my husband does use the hair dryer every day. So that's his side of the sink. You can see it's simple, it's easy to reach in. Even though these are stacked, the travel bags at the bottom we don't use every day, he doesn't use every day, so he doesn't have to access that all the time. And then let's move on to my side of the bathroom sink. You can see here on the inside of the doors, I have used command hooks, and I wrap the curling irons. They are different sizes. And on there, just to utilize the space behind the cabinet door. And also with some extra loofahs that I have, you can see they're in the inside of that middle bar that we always have under sinks. And I've used also a command hook there. And then you can see here with the sliding door what I've done. I've learned this from Alejandra Costello, where she just takes scrap paper and puts it behind, and it just makes it look prettier. I have here the hot rollers, and they were just from, I think, Ulta. And I have a flat iron, and then my hot curling iron, which is like the 1.5 inch kind. And I do have a mirror there, like that. And then this one I really, really love. I use this also for travel. It's a bag just for your flat iron. This is what the bag looks like inside. It was $4.99 from Ross, but you know, I haven't seen it since. You can always use a hand towel and wrap your hot styling equipment in a hand towel. Of course, I always let it cool off first, but I just love it. I think it fits perfectly in my bag. These are the other hair curlers. There's a hairbrush in there, and then these are the ones that are not electrical. And I use these a lot for Cicely too, when it's time to curl her hair for like special events, like a father-daughter dance. And then in this drawer, I just have cotton swabs and extra makeup towelettes, and then our Q-tips. And then down there are feminine products. And then also here in the middle, because you know you have that pipe, and the key to this is just working with the system to try to figure out a configuration, basically. So there are more curlers, you know, big round curlers there, the the ones that you leave in your hair, and those fit perfectly. I do have, you can't see it here, but I do have a couple cosmetic bags in the back. And then on this sliding drawer, so you could see that these, I actually ran out of paper. I wanted to make them both pink, but it worked out that these are pink polka dots and these are like a dark gray polka dot. And so I think that's better that they weren't all the same. So I know the left side is the pink and then the right side are the dark gray. And, you know, I can kind of delineate it more what's on what side. But here on top, I have, this is a container with a handle that I got from the container store a long time ago. And this is where I keep facials, sugar scrubs, and spa products. So you just pull it out like that. And you can see inside, I have this one is from Secret. It's like those, it's a mask. And then there's, these are just all sugar scrubs. Here is a little container for all my lipsticks and lip liners. I think I got that free from Clinique, the container at least. This makeup kit was from Ulta and I got it a little while ago. It does have a built-in mirror, and then here's just some eyeshadows and stuff. And then in here, you just open it up. They do have a holder there for brushes that I've obviously used. And here's the lipstick compartment. And then this is the blush compartment. Here, you can see that I've used a two containers that are divided into three. I got those from Target. And that's a lipstick container. And then this is a cream cheese container. I've contained all of my little, you know, eyebrow pencils and brushes for the eyebrows specifically. You know, the top one is for eyes and lips. This is for face. So just some extra stuff, you know, like stuff from Philosophy. So this is underneath our master bathroom sink and how I've organized it. You can see that I've tried to utilize the space on the cabinet doors behind this piece of wood here. And then with the sliding doors, just to make them a little bit prettier, aside from labeling them, just putting some scrapbook paper and just not having this place overstuffed. Please comment below how you organize underneath the master bathroom sink and maybe any other tips and tricks that you have and you'd love to share with this YouTube community. If you like this video and you're not yet a subscriber, please subscribe. We do love showing you our different organization projects throughout the house, and we will see you in the next video. Bye.
Thanks for watching livelovelatte.net. You can also find us on Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest, and Instagram.